Rico. That's JD in for dibs. And I know, believe me, as a parent of three children, I know all about the phrase, it's not fair. And I look at my kids all the time and I go, why on earth are you even asking for that? That doesn't exist. Don't give me it's not fair. My gosh, you live in the Bay Area, California. Please, if we want to take a look at the earth, your life has been the fairest thing that you will ever experience. So we have that conversation all of the time. It's hard to go out in the world and ask for fair. It's not fair. But let's be honest here. Someone help me with this equation. And you know we love talking to you. And Brian Baldinger is going to join us in 10 minutes. Joe Theismann at 10. Former Seahawk Robert Turbin is on the show today as well. 888-957-9570. That's our Comcast business text line. And good morning, Twitch and YouTube. We see you like you see us. We'll be looking at your comments and responding for sure. So someone help me with this equation. If we can all agree that it is completely unfair to Trey Lance to say you need to play well right now at age 22 in your fourth start. If that's totally unfair, okay, fine. Isn't it also totally unfair to ask veteran players who are a bunch of Pro Bowlers and a fan base that's been to two of the last three NFC championships, isn't it also unfair to tell them to be patient?
It is, but that's reality and life. And the 49ers thought that they were good enough to thread the needle. They thought they were good enough to do both, to have Trey Lance play at a certain level, but be good enough in other areas to where, on the one hand, you're developing him, on the other hand, you're winning football games at a level to where those veterans are kept at bay in terms of you feeling like you owe them to go to Jimmy Garoppolo. The other part of this, too, Mark, the goalposts are different. The goalposts are different, and I hear you. That's not fair either. But Jimmy Garoppolo does have a track record of putting up the numbers that he puts up and having it coincide with winning football games at a 70% clip. That he gets more. We're talking about the leash and the leeway, and last year they were 2-4, and they were 3-5, and it was ugly. Well, you're going to be less apt to go to a young quarterback, a rookie at that point, than you are with the script flipped this year in a situation where you've got an inexperienced second-year guy and a guy who's wanted a 70% clip behind him. Trey doesn't get the leash that Jimmy Garoppolo got last year. That's just reality.
Well, look, I mean, there are comparisons, actually, in my opinion, right now that we need to stop, which is, comparing what Trey Lance is going to do in said game versus what Jimmy Garoppolo is going to do in said game. You're absolutely right. I don't care if you think Jimmy won the games or not. They're on his record. He has been to multiple playoff runs in this league. He has a winning record. He has that thing, okay? He's got a resume, and Trey Lance doesn't. Let me give you another one, because I've heard this a couple of times just in the last couple of days. Hey, what about the other quarterbacks from last year's draft? It's not like they're playing well either. Irrelevant. Completely and totally irrelevant, and let me tell you why. They're not 49ers. Period. I don't care if Trevor Lawrence is playing well. He's a Jaguar. He's got nothing around him. Zach Wilson is at the most dysfunctional franchise I've seen in the last 20 years easily. Plus, he's hurt. Mac Jones has a defensive coordinator calling plays for him now and a back injury. And we watched Justin Fields. And while you guys want to hang a W on him, I sat in the end zone last week and watched someone who on about 90% of the plays had no chance. Absolutely no chance, albeit going against a really good defense. So that is the path for Trey Lance. And I said this to Sean Salisbury yesterday. I went from last year going, oh my gosh, Trey Lance is the luckiest young quarterback in the history of ever. All these other guys are going to be Jets and Jaguars. And this guy gets Kyle Shanahan. Unbelievable. What a lucky stroke. And now I sit here as he is given the keys to the car. Jimmy Garoppolo is still on the roster, and the world is telling him he stinks after one game. And I go, you know what? I think it's the opposite. He's got my sympathy. This is not a workable situation for him.
Well, I would disagree there. I think it is workable. It's workable by going out and playing well.
Well, right, but
like,
is that...
Like, that's not impossible. I don't think that's impossible. That's where maybe that's where I do disagree with you a little bit.
I mean, it's not impossible if it's Patrick Mahomes. He's the one who went out year two and just was awesome right away.
But he doesn't have to be Patrick Mahomes.
He's not. So good.
But
you got to go win.
But for me, it was always two different scoreboards on that front. It was, you have to be solid enough, steady enough, competent enough to win with everything else you have around you this year. That's one scoreboard. The other scoreboard is you were the number three pick and they gave up a couple of picks and swapped and all of that. So your career arc needs to be closer to Mahomes or Josh Allen. But that's not that. I don't know how long I'm giving you, but it ain't 2022 where I'm judging on that category.
No,
probably
I'm not
at least till 2024.
I'm not even really going to ask you to ever be Mahomes. Mahomes is probably going to be a Hall of Famer someday.
But look more like that guy or those two guys at some point in your career.
I mean,
never on the table for me in 2022. It was be a different version or a better version or your own version, kind of Jimmy. But part of that is, you got to win.
They got to win.
Part of that is you got to win.
And is that fair at age 22?
Yes.
At age 22?
I think it is.
Okay. Then you've found the one lane where it's fair, except for how many times, if he doesn't win, like last week, if he doesn't play well, all I hear, well, hold on a second. Be fair. He's 22. It's his third start. Again, we just looked at the schedule. Is that what you all want? All of you who are saying, be patient. Are you going to be patient next week? Dun, 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 bada, 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 and here comes Russell Wilson. And ladies and gentlemen, it's the 0-2 San Francisco 49ers, quarterbacked by Trey Lance and his quarterback rating of 78.9. That's on NBC in 9 days if this doesn't go well.
Well, and if you are 0-2 and you're in that position, to me it's – and then he goes out there and plays poorly against Denver – at that point, but hear me out.
Yeah.
At that point, it's not going to be, what did you do against Denver? It's going to be, you lost those first two games that you needed to win. Because that's where,
yes,
I just keep coming back to it. If you're 2-0 going to Denver and he throws three picks and they play a bad game and Denver beats you, so what? Yes. You're 2-1. Everything's still on schedule at that point. You go home and play the Rams. Let's see what happens next. He wouldn't be invincible at that point, but when you don't win the first game, that does change the calculus.
Gosh,
it does.
They messed this up.
When
last
your
week.
Explosive plays
they
don't lead to touchdowns,
yep.
Like that's the other thing. Like you count 3-4 explosive plays that they made, a 20-yarder to what was it, McLeod, 30-yarder to Ayuk, and then Jennings had the 44-yarder, all that. Well, Justin Fields, he couple plays he made. Well, they led to touchdowns.
It's so wild. They messed this up so bad by losing this game last week.
Yeah.
They messed this up so bad. Anybody who watched the game, you watched the whole first half, you can tell physically who's the better team. It wasn't even close.
And Trey was fine.
And he's fine.
He was solid.
I was excited at halftime.
Not perfect, but...
I was super bummed that I couldn't get a hot dog, but I was excited about Trey. Long line for the bathroom, too. But then they had the trough.
Oh, yeah.
I'm like, oh, I'm a candlestick. Yeah. Look at this.
Candlestick vibes at Soldier Field, for sure.
It's all sponsored by BMW. Now open in the Fairfield Auto Mall. They provide a luxurious, all-encompassing experience to address all your BMW needs. Visit BMWFairfield.com today to book your visit. It's BMWFairfield.com. That's JD. He's in for dibs. We are going to get to your phone calls. So hang in there, 888-957-9570, because we've also got Baldy time. Let's get into the Baldy breakdown. Brian Baldinger joins us next on 95.7 The Game.